Well, joining us now, we are talking about communities in schools of Cameron County, and we are talking about a specific event that's coming up with a very fun title. But joining us, we have Eva Perez, who's the executive director. I want to thank you so much for coming in this morning.
Thank you for inviting us.
Thank you. So, Eva, tell us a little bit about Community in Schools of Cameron County and kind of what you all do.
So Community in Schools is a nonprofit organization, and it's basically a drop-off prevention program.
Okay.
So we have we work with students that are at risk of dropping out.
Okay.
And currently we're at Brownsville, San Benito, and Harlingen. Mm-hmm. No, I'm sorry, in Los Presnos. Mm-hmm. And so we work with students that have been identified by the district as possibly dropping out.
Wow.
And so we have students that have attendance problems, mm-hmm. academics, and basic needs. Wow. And so we have a case manager that's placed inside the school district. Mm-hmm. They have a caseload of 100 students that they assess, and they provide services throughout the year. Mm-hmm. And so our main objective, which is our mission, is to make sure that our students get all the resources they need in order for them to be promoted to the next grade level.
Of course.
Or to graduate. And we encourage going into college or vocational, whatever skill that they might need in order for them to have a better life.
Most definitely. Mm-hmm. And is it something that you get invited to the schools from the school that they feel that they have the need, or is it, how does that kind of work?
Currently the way it works is that our funding comes from TA.
Okay.
And so we partner up with the districts, and like I mentioned, Brownsville, Los Fresnos, and San Benito. Mm-hmm. We've been in Cameron County for, come July, we're going to have 25 years. Wow. Celebrating our 25th anniversary. And so our program is very well needed in the schools because, mm-hmm. we do a lot of one-on-one with a student, and our teachers are basically busy teaching.
Of course.
And so we have these students that need additional help, and that's where our site coordinator will come in and give services to each of the students depending on their needs. Mm-hmm. And so we bond with the students, and the students will come to us because we advocate for them.
Most definitely.
And so it's just another helping hand for the student.
Most definitely. And what have you seen as far as in the students when you've kind of made that relationship with them and kind of identified those students who did need that kind of extra help or kind of extra push? What has been the reception as far as the students and, again, the family as well, because it is a kind of a whole unit?
Yes. Well, actually, this program, we not only just work with the student, but we also work with the parents.
Oh, wow.
Because it takes a community
of
to raise the students. So it's the school district, communities in school, the student, and the parents. Mm-hmm. And so we do a growth plan to see what's working for that child. And if it doesn't work, we'll reunite and we'll discuss, and we'll try to find a plan that actually meets the needs of that student. Mm-hmm. As far as the students are concerned, I started as a site coordinator back in 2006, mm-hmm. 2006, and I still go to Walmart and I see my students, and they come up to me and say, "Ms. Perez, do you remember me?" And I look at them, and they're so tall, and they say, "Remember, you helped me, and if it wasn't for you that you gave me the support, you wow. encouraged me for me to continue the whole." Well, I already graduated. I'm an engineer, and
wow.
so those are our success stories.
That amazing.
We do impact the lives, and sometimes all it takes is they just want someone to listen to them.
Mm-hmm.
That's all they want, and so we're there for them,
of course, and
that makes a difference in their lives.
Definitely, mm-hmm. of course. I mean, there is a lot, as you mentioned, teachers are trying to teach the entire classroom, and they
yes.
are very large classrooms with a lot of students. And then parents, you know, they're trying to provide for their families, and
mm-hmm.
then, you know, they have siblings. It becomes a lot. So
yes,
I think what
does.
You all are doing is fantastic, allowing to give them that extra help, that extra person to make contact with,
yes.
To know that they're not alone and that there's help out there for
yes.
them. So as you've mentioned, some of the success stories, you know, at different engineers
mm-hmm.
or whatever they do choose to become, obviously it is working and it does
yes.
help. And so with that being said, of course, different fundraising events are what kind of keep your doors open and you
yes.
able to continue helping these students.
Yes.
And you have one coming up, which
yes.
is the Girls Just Want to Have Fun event. So tell us a little bit about
yes.
that.
So this is our 8th annual event, and this took part about 8 years ago. TA cut some of our funding,
mm-hmm.
and so we decided to do a fundraiser. And so there's so many fundraisers out there, so we want it to be unique.
Of course. So
we said, let's do a Girls Just Want to Have Fun night out. And this is an event for 21 and over females of all ages. Mm-hmm. You have to be 21 because we give out wine. Mm-hmm. And so it's a night to pamper the female because we do a lot. Mm-hmm. I mean, we're mothers, we're taxis, we soccer moms. We've got so many titles. Mm-hmm. And so we said, why not pamper the female and have her night out? And so it's an event that takes place on June 20 from 6 to 10. And so we sell the ticket for $25, and the client in return will get beauty services from makeup to hair done, their nails. We've got 15 to 20 restaurants that they are going to be offering samples of their product, their food, and so they're entitled to go and taste that. We have 40 vendors that you can do shopping, and then we also have entertainment. We have a DJ going on for line dancing, and we have a silent auction as well. And so we put all of this together because this is what females like. They like to shop, they like to beauty themselves, they like to eat, and then they like to have fun. Definitely. So we thought that this would be an excellent fundraiser. And it has been a great success, because this is our 8th annual, and the public continues wanting more of it.
Definitely. I mean, it sounds perfect. You have food, entertainment, you can shop, and then you get to also be pampered, which is fantastic. Mm-hmm. Especially, I think it's great because it is after a work day, so whether you are out at a business or you're in an office somewhere or you are taking your kids, you just had a long day at the house, whatever you may be doing, whatever your work day consists of, I think it's a perfect way to kind of unwind, de-stress, and kind of take in the evening with just fellow women out there also who are kind of, you know, had a day themselves and are ready to relax. So I think it's fantastic. All the while you are helping and contributing to communities and schools of Cameron County, which I think is fantastic, because you are doing an amazing thing. And so they work hand in hand together. So 8 years obviously means it has been a success. And I think that's fantastic. What other things do you guys do throughout the year to kind of contribute to the organization?
We do have at the beginning of the school year, we have back to school, school supply drives for our kids, because we service 2,564 students. And so some of these families can't afford school supplies. So through local banks, they provide drop boxes for school supplies. And so we collect the supplies and we give them out at the beginning of the school year. We also do in November, we do a Thanksgiving dinner for the residents of San Benito, because Brownsville and Harlingen have that Thanksgiving dinner, but San Benito doesn't, and transportation is a big deal.
Right.
So we've done, the past 2 years, we've done a Thanksgiving dinner for about 250 families there in San Benito. Christmas, we have toys for our children, and so we give up about 3,000 toys for our students as well. So we try to give the things that other children are receiving because our kids don't have the means.
Of
and
course.
So we try to emphasize, and it's been, the public has really given us a lot of support. Communities come in and they donate, and so we do the purchases to try to give our children, all the children, what everybody else is having.
Well, I want to thank you so much for coming in today. I really greatly appreciate it. I think it's fantastic what you're doing. And of course, folks, if you want to go ahead and purchase tickets, that number you can call on your screen, or to stay up to date with all the things that they're doing, or if you just want to help out in any way, you can go ahead and visit their website. Eva, thank you again so much for coming in today. I appreciate
it. Thank you.